Math 31, I had a question coming out of section 5.6, number 29, and here we were asked to find the end behavior of a function. So you see me repeating this time and time again. Before I'm going to do anything, if I've got a rational function, let me find the domain first. Because if I have a fraction, I really need to worry about when is the denominator equal to zero. So here you see me setting my denominator equal to zero, and then I set each factor equal to zero after I factor it. And then I get these two numbers. So I have problems, and yes, they're fractions, but it's at 1/3 and negative 5/2. So our denominator zeros out at these two values. So the domain is going to be all real numbers except those two values. You can think of the number line, right? If I went from negative infinity to infinity, my domain would be all real numbers except for I need to put a hole at negative 5/2. And I need to put a hole at positive 1/3. And let me see if I can get in here. Oops, no, the eraser didn't make that any better. I was hoping it would just erase at those points. Let me erase it and just show you a better number line so that we can see where our end game is. So my domain would be from negative infinity, right? I have a problem at negative 5/2. I have a problem at 1/3. And then we go positive infinity. So I need all this, all of this, and all of this. And that's where I'm coming up with my domain here. Now, that wasn't the question asked of me, but I wanted to get my domain and just remind you that anytime you have a place where just your denominator zeros out, you automatically have vertical asymptotes there. But how do we get the end behavior here? Well, if you have a function and you have this rational function, you look at the highest degree terms on the numerator and denominator. So for right now, my highest degree terms, I've got a 2x squared and a 6x squared. And because those exponents are the same, we're just going to look at that ratio of the highest terms, right? And then the x squareds actually cancel out because they are the same power. You're looking at 2/6, which reduces to 1/3. So that's how I get my horizontal asymptote at y equals 1/3. And anytime the degree in the denominator is equal to the degree in the numerator, you're going to take a ratio of the lead coefficients, and that's going to be the horizontal asymptote. So I will always have a horizontal asymptote. It'll be at the y value, or it will have the equation y equals whatever that ratio was. So in this case, 2/6 was 1/3. There's my horizontal asymptote. All right, thanks so much, everyone. Bye.